holy and innocent light of love. To accept the holiness that is within you, that is the truth of your being, is to accept life itself. The true life, the life of love, the life of eternal movement and beauty, the never-ending love, the never-ending light. No beginning, no end, eternally true. In the willingness to accept this divine state, this normal divine state, is to relinquish all of the identity that has been made to be used to defend, to protect against a fantasized enemy. Every story is the same story. Every beloved believes their story is different, exclusive. But it's truly all the same. The belief of pain and suffering, the belief of limitation and separation, and ultimately, and surrounding everything, belief in death. The belief that you are a body that will fall away and that you will cease to exist. And that you believe that everyone who has stepped out of the body has ceased to exist in some way. The welcome home of eternal life. The welcome home of eternal existence in peace and joy and harmony, being all that there is, and the willingness to accept this divine truth. These are not lofty ideas. These are not for some other time. These are the callings of love in this moment. The willingness to embrace and follow and listen and commune and joyously open the heart where all joy exists. This is the journey of becoming undefended. The journey that really has no distance. And yet, because you have believed in time, because you have believed in a separate self, the journey is a place of grace. The place of acceptance, the place of trust in something beyond what you have known, beyond the evidence that's been made, beyond the perceptions of limitation. In this moment, finding the willingness of the heart to surrender the past, just easily surrendering into the hands of God, accepting the divine help of love's power, the healing power of love. To accept the divine alchemy of unraveling a false identity and accepting its ease and gentleness as you surrender all resistance, the resistance to being right, the resistance to being undefended, and to realize there's nothing to be right about. Everything that you have known has been a temporary identity. Accepting the holiness, the innocence, the beauty that waits in the heart as the heart relinquishes its defense through your choice. And as you surrender the past, finding the willingness to surrender the future so that you can truly be in the present. Resting gently in trust that the future can unfold in perfect harmony if it is surrendered into the hands of God. Resting in that trust. That the journey of love is a joyful one. Accepting that the journey of love can be happily accepted as the false identity falls away by choice. Step by step, trusting the journey. Step by step. Waking up each morning with joy in the heart. What will this day bring of grace? What will this day bring of love? What will this day hold in its perfection? Love. Everywhere you look, every thought given to love. And moment to moment, learning to bless, learning to see the light in everything and in everyone, learning to trust the way of love, learning from all the masters and guides that are so lovingly surrounding every beloved. The willingness to be in awareness and accept the masters and guides is a place of happiness, a place of union with all beings, the willingness to walk with all divine guides that completely serve your journey of love. in the journey of separation, everyone has experienced themselves as alone, bereft of help, bereft of connection, of the heart. The concept of aloneness can be now be let go. Not needing to cling to anything, but opening the heart and returning to union of total equality, of total harmony and peace. Accepting the holiness, the light, the truth of your divine self. And in that self, the little self disappears. Never really true to begin with. The illusion falls away as the heart says yes. How simple. How perfect. And each moment is the call to breathe. Breathing. Fully. With purpose to remember love. The willingness to truly be here, remembering. And as you breathe, breathing into the harmony, breathing and opening, no longer wanting or attempting to control anything, and recognizing with great joy there is nothing to control. And breathing deeply and fully, resting the mind, resting the mind and with the body following. Resting in God, trusting, all unfolding, the willingness to surrender outcomes, all situations and their believed outcomes, as if the knowing of the past would not bring you anything else but again the past. And now wanting the outcomes to be of love's healing. Surrendering with every breath all beliefs of right and wrong, good and bad, opinions, likes and dislikes, and accepting everything. Accepting and inviting love to unfold. Breathing, surrendering the heart, filling the heart with sacred breath, and consciously bringing the heart forward. Consciously letting the rays of love pour from the heart by your intention, and affirming there is nothing to defend, nothing to protect. You're here to love. and here to remember love. Breathing, allowing, wanting to be shown the way, feeling within the heart the yes, show me the way, recognizing I don't know the way, but you will show me the way, love will show me the way. I follow happily, joyously. I follow, letting the mind go, returning the mind to God, no longer willing to have the mind held in separation, filled with a personal identity, believed to be temporary, but now surrendered. Saying yes to love. And breathing. Happy. Happy to be on the journey of love. And to surrender the past and all lifetimes. Willing to be here, present in this moment, in peace and harmony and joy. And breathing. Breathing and affirming that here in the infinite circle of love, we are one. Only one heart. How can this be? And yet, one heart. The willingness to be taken, for the one heart to be revealed in its truth, in divine union. All beloveds. Returning to where you never really left, returning where you have always truly been, just awakening to the truth of love, and affirming the sanctuary is filled with love. Love is all that exists. This universe is all love. There is only one presence here. It is the life force of God. And the willingness of acceptance of the life force of God to accept that it is all that exists, and the willingness to merge in this oneness, in this life force of God, to return to the awareness of the true self. One heart. One life. One love. Breathing and affirming.
Okay, just a minute and a half.
Breathing and affirming. And the willingness, as the seeming journey unfolds, to be the servant of love, to find the devotion, the dedication, the yes, to serve humanity's remembering. By remembering the truth of your heart. Only love. as this prayer is sung, let it sing through your heart and recognize the divine vibration of the calling of love, the calling to peace, the calling to remember, joining in that divine energy field. Come along, brother, let's go on this path of light and love. Come along, sister, let's go on this path of light and love with our Father and our Mother, and letting all pain go. Let us pray and work for this goal. It's the task of our lives. I see the Spirit. I see my soul. I see the light in me. As my heart opens like a flower, I become the living God. I create and I am created within the oneness of all. On this path of light and love, letting all pain go, letting all perceptions of pain go, all perceptions of battle, all perceptions of the need for defense that show up in various situations and are the habits of the past. But now is the time for love to shine, to be recognized, to be remembered, to be embraced, letting all pain go. Pain that has been self-inflicted, not coming from anything outside, but the belief that has been held by humanity of self-loathing, now surrendered. Through your yes, humanity heals. And as the heart opens like a flower, you recognize that you are the living God, the creation of God, and the willingness to accept that divine realization, and to join with all life in this truth of union, and that you create as you are created, that you create only through God, that you create through the heart of love with God, within the oneness of all creation expresses itself. Lord, 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 my beloved Master, Lord, 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 my heart. Here I present myself to fulfill this journey of love. Here I present myself with all of my heart. I ask my beloved mother to guide me with your love. I ask my beloved mother with all of my heart. Oh, my mother, my beloved mother, guide this journey so that I may remember that every step I take is in your hand. As I say yes, Divine Father, show me the way. I won't fall down. I won't be alone as I remember our divine union. Here at your feet, I kneel with humility. Here at your feet, I say yes to the charity of love and the divine transformation. I join in the healing of all of humanity. With humility in my heart, I am here to offer love. In the name of truth, in the name of holiness, in the name of the one heart. Señor, 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 me has llamado. Señor, 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 meu coração, aqui a me apresento para cumprir minha missão. Aqui a me apresento de todo meu coração. Eu peço a minha mãe me guiar com vosso amor. Eu peço a minha mãe de todo meu coração. Oh mãe amada, guiar esta missão. Cada passo que dê esteja em vossa mão. Aqui em vossos pés me ajo com humildade. Aqui a vossos pés eu peço e caridade. A todos eu curar com humildade meu coração. A todos eu curar em nome da salvação. To find the willingness of the heart to kneel in humility, to kneel down in humility and recognize, I don't know anything. I don't know what anything means. I don't know how to look on anything. Everything that I've looked on in the past has been the belief of separation. And now, with the yes of my heart, I ask for help. Lord, 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 my Master, Lord, my heart, take me, take me, take me. Show me the way. Show me the way that I haven't walked before and don't remember. Show me the way home. I've forgotten my home. A veil has dropped and has obscured my awareness of the oneness. I'm willing now for this veil to lift and for the heart to heal completely and return to love. Lord, show me the way. With humility in my heart, I surrender and affirm my willingness to serve all of love, to serve humanity with my whole heart, to serve every moment in remembering love. Lord, my heart, take my heart and lead me. I'm willing for the heart to open. I'm willing to let go of all fear, all belief in the need to protect and defend. Lord, 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 my heart, I say yes. From the depth of my heart, from the depth of my being, it is what I truly want. I say yes. The power of love shows itself in so many unexpected ways. That's the purpose of staying in the not knowing, to allow love to navigate the way for you, to navigate what's most helpful. And that can't be known from the past, but love remembers and shows the way. In all different beautiful ways, love shows the way. In this moment, Love calls you to this beautiful offering. Stop calling me a pregnant woman. My master once entered a phase that whenever I would see him, he would say, "How did you ever become a pregnant woman?" And I would reply, "My dear teacher, you must be speaking the truth, but of all of what you say is a mystery to me." Many months passed in his blessed company, but one day I lost my patience upon hearing that old refrain and blurted out, "Stop calling me a pregnant woman." And my master replied, "Someday, my sweet one, all the nonsense in your brain will dry up like a stagnant pool of water beneath the sun. Though if you want to know the truth, I can so clearly see that God has made love with you and the whole universe is germinating inside your belly. And wonderful words, such enlightened words, will take birth from you and be cradled against thousands of hearts." We never know how the healings will arrive. We never know the vehicle that will bring the perfect teaching. We never know what will be most helpful. To accept the journey, to give yourself to the journey. Consciously and consistently is to let every day open with newness, a new day that has no connection to the past as deeply as possible. To accept each new day and its gifts, and to accept that there is a divine alchemy of love that is moving in this divine orchestration for your own healing. Custom made just for you. Can't compare it to anybody else's. Can't compare the progress, can't compare or discern what it all means, can't figure out, "Oh, well, this happened yesterday, so then tomorrow this should happen." In that mind illness, healing stops because the mind has said, "I know." The mind has said, "It's fine, I got it figured out. I have it figured out because I saw what happened yesterday, and in my mind, I will now know what happens tomorrow." And in that insanity, pain returns. Suffering returns. Because the belief in separation is reinforced again. And yet love keeps calling. And love keeps inviting to trust the way of love, to trust the path that you have been given, that you have been called to, and to trust its divine unfolding. The mind would like to, in its insanity, look at time and judge the amount of time that this is taking, and judge it as either accepted or not accepted according to what the mind's approval rating is of that day. But the place of deep healing is in the not knowing and the learning to trust day by day, deeper and deeper, that everything is divinely orchestrated and that there's nothing to worry about. There is nothing to be concerned about as the journey unfolds. You can almost hear the voice of God whispering, "Relax, I've got this. Just follow. Just allow. Stop trying to take the reins and think you know something. Follow. I have sent you masters. I have sent you gifts. I have sent you everything that you need. Everything is here. Because of your yes, everything is in perfect harmony. Everything that comes up for healing is in perfection. Everything that you find yourself pushing up against is in perfection. And the more that you trust, the more you step into that leap of faith that the future is not the past, except if you make it so, that you can trust the unfolding. To trust, that the whole universe is germinating within you, waiting to be recognized. And to trust that someday all the nonsense in your brain will dry up like a stagnant pool of water beneath the sun. And at some place in this exquisite healing, you will be so happy because at last you will recognize, oh, that's where all the pain was coming from. The world believes that to be without the mind of knowing is disastrous. But that little identification says, the power of God is, I have decided, a very limited source, a very limited idea. And I'm cautious, I'm wary. And my resistance is my friend. Day by day, as you keep saying yes, you will begin to really recognize where the pain is coming from. That the pain is self-inflicted and need not be. It can be surrendered. It can be let go. It's just trust. Trust in the divine of the universe. Trust in every master that has ever walked on this earth. Trusting that they were, before becoming masters, before awakening to the truth, that they were all in the same place of following their heart, of following a deep, deep calling that was found deep, deep within that they couldn't even understand, that they couldn't even make sense of in any way according to the world. And yet they followed. They followed and opened the doorways so that others could follow. And with each one following, more confidence in trust, more devotion, more surrender, more joy in the journey, until the realization comes that there is no need for pain in the journey. that there is no need for struggle in the journey. That the resistance again is self-inflicted. When Hafiz would have his master say, "How did you ever become a pregnant woman?" And he was called to accept this. He was called to accept this truth and to accept that it was all a mystery to him. And yet, it's what was offered. He could accept it and want the blessings of this divine mystery that was being offered in this teaching, or he could analyze it and find his own twist and spin on it of what he thought it meant and whether he accepted it or not, whether he approved of it or not. And as he was busy possibly conjuring up a resistance and a knowing, it wasn't available for the love that was being offered. Letting go of approval, letting go of analyzing, letting go of all thoughts about the outside, what you think you know about it, what you think it means, all of it allows you then, when you let that all go, it allows you in your light and humility, it allows you to enter into the mysteries of divine transformation. They are mysteries because they're not known here on this earth plane. Here on this earth plane, everything is concrete. Everything is housed in a temporary body. Not just other beloveds, but everything. Every stick of furniture. Every element is housed in a body that is temporary, that will fall away.
Mm-hmm.
And the mysteries of love, the mysteries of the universe, have to be entered through the heart, the willingness to be taken, to be led, to rest in God. And recognize that you aren't doing anything except saying yes. You may move within this world and become, in your awareness, in your acceptance, to accept that you can be the hole in the flute, that you can be the vehicle of love, the instrument of love. But that is for remembering also. It isn't to gain anything. It isn't to achieve anything. It's to remember. Let everything be used for love. Let everything be used by spirit. And join. Let yourself be taken on the journey of love. As you go into the cave of the mysteries of love, let the guide lead you that knows the way. Be in that divine yes of, "I don't know, but you will show me." Be the child that is willing to learn. Find that trusting place where every moment unfolds and is brand new. Every moment, just now. All love and the willingness to enter into that divine state. Many months passed by in his blessed company, but one day I lost my patience upon hearing the old refrain and blurted out, "Stop calling me a pregnant woman." In this divine teaching, the student learns of resistance. The student begins to see the resistance is not the friend, and the willingness to come back to sanity again and again and again and accept the offering of the moment. Someday, the master says, all the nonsense in your brain will dry up like a stagnant pool of water beneath the sun. The closer you come to the happiness of having this accomplished, the sooner the battleground will dry up. The willingness to have the brain dried up like stagnant water in the sun is the self-realization that this brain is not the friend of love. It is filled with concepts of hatred.
Hmm.
It's filled with concepts of separation. It's filled with evidence from the past. It's filled with a story of a separate identification. And in that constant running, separation is constantly affirmed. And those memories, those beliefs from the past are so readily available. In a flash, you're right there. In a flash, you're in suspicion. In a flash, you're in caution. In a flash, you think you know. Open to the gratitude of having the brain dried up, of truly wanting to surrender what you thought you knew about the past, and be willing, so very willing, with the whole heart, to forgive that mistaken identity, and to forgive the mistaken identity of all identities that were given to everyone. To truly want to set everyone free. To truly want to release all beloveds from the past. To truly want to accept that God has made love with you and germinated the whole universe within you. To accept the mysteries of the universe as the truth of who you are.
Mm-hmm.
Not less, not limited, divinely eternal. To look at the sky and to recognize that every light that appears in the sky is the reflection of God and is God and is you, and the willingness to step out of this meager identification and humbly accept the universe as the light that you are. Not because you're more than, but because all is love.
Mm.
To step into that divine union, that unity, that oneness, letting all pain go, to become the awareness of a living God, truly living eternally, truly being that eternal light, no longer shying away from it, no longer resisting, no longer believing that you can't measure up to being the light of the universe. There is nothing in your identity that you've made in the belief of separation that will measure up. But there is the truth of you, the truth of your one exquisite self that is waiting to be discovered, waiting to be accepted. The wonderful words, the enlightened words, will take birth from you as you open your heart and let love flow. Let the Holy Spirit speak. Nothing to take credit for, just love speaking. Because love loves. Love is. You are that. All that is. No more settling. The willingness to accept. The peace of God is everything that I want. Let this be in your heart every moment. It's the choice. It's the choice that must be made and has to be made by you. What you want is what you will experience. If you want to be right, you will experience pain and suffering. If you want to be cautious, you will experience pain and suffering. If you want to believe that you are without and that something is missing and that there is something to get or something to protect in the world, you will experience a painful existence of never getting. You will see, you will experience what you want and what you put your faith in. That is the law of the universe. You have choice. And that is why all the masters and guides call all beloveds to the truth, so that you recognize you have a choice. For the first time, in all of these lifetimes, you are stepping out of the identity of being a victim, that your life was done to you, that your life was not a conscious choice. And now, in the truth of love, the truth of choice shines its bright light. It's a temporary place, a temporary place of divine grace to choose. To choose love, to choose peace. The peace of God is everything I want. To have that ringing in your heart, to have that singing in your heart instead of the habits from the past. This is a divine replacement so that the path unfolds easily. With you as a divine participant, joining in the calling to return to love. The peace of God is everything I want. It is the purpose of my life. It is my function. It is all that I want. That affirming, that divine purpose and decision will open all the doors. It's already heard. It's heard the moment that it entered into your possibilities. But then to hold that, to hold what you truly want, and recognize you have the power within you of choosing the truth or the lies. Constantly choosing and affirming and living in the brilliance of the heart as it opens, the willingness to embrace every beloved as the Christ, to embrace every creature as the divinity of God, to the willingness to embrace that everything of life is of God, and to want to see that light, to want the peace of God. And in that wanting, transformation is guaranteed. No one will be left without that truly wants to remember, that even has the little willingness to transform. But the more willingness you have, the easier the road. The more willingness, the easier, because the resistance falls away more and more. And all the resistance, it can show up in a million different ways, but its major way is I know. The major stumbling block of healing is I know. And how simple it is to surrender. I know. Stop calling me a pregnant woman speaks to this knowing. Stop calling me a pregnant woman. I know I'm not. I have the evidence. This was said to a man. Not possible. Don't call me a pregnant woman. And yet, how perfect. Because all of the teaching in that beautiful offering was to let go of what you think you know and accept something that is beyond this existence in a temporary identity. That the Master sees that God has germinated the entire universe in your being, and to accept all the divine teachings that show up all day long. Be available. Are the habits entrenched? It seems so. But even that, even if you look through the lens of suspicion, and you look through the lens of resistance, and you look through the lens of impatience, it doesn't mean anything either. The power of love is in charge. The power of love has no limitation for healing. There is nothing that can't be healed. It's only the arrogance of the ego that says, I know. I know what can be healed. I know what is difficult. I know how it works. Instead of, I don't know how healing works. I don't have a clue, because everything that the mind, the brain, is attached to is time, differences, levels, degrees, comparisons, and none of that has anything to do with healing. The power of healing has no limitation. only the call for willingness to not know. Only the call to put every situation, to put every outcome, to put every day into the hands of God and to follow. To relinquish your belief in your own authority. And the strange thing about the belief of authority is that the belief of authority has two sides to the coin, as all duality does. The two sides of the coin of the belief of your own authority is one, I'm a victim and I'm helpless and I am too damaged and I am too this and I am too that and I have a right to be fearful and I have a right to be stubborn and I have a right to my belief that I need to be in charge. I have a right to all this. And the other side of the same coin of resistance, the belief that I'm not a victim, but I'm damn going to make my own way and be in charge and know everything and make it to the top and prove myself. Neither one is true. Both are being called to be relinquished because neither is true. Doesn't matter which side of the coin it's on. It's not true. To let go of the belief that you know how and what healing should look like. No one knows. That's the trusting of this divine alchemy of love and the power of transformation that is the truth of the universe and the willingness to accept that power and accept that healing and let it all be transformed moment to moment. Trusting that you will not be annihilated, that you will not be without, that all that's being relinquished is what's been made up, that was never real to begin with. A delusional state of separation, a delusional state of temporariness within the belief of time, to accept your eternal truth, your eternal life, and to serve that love with love. To accept the miracles and the mysteries of healing. To be filled with awe at the power of love and its transformation. To be filled with humility. At the power of love and its transformation. To accept and hold so dearly, so tightly, the promise that in this world everything can be healed because the stars said so. The stars said so. Everything in this world can be healed. And the holding on to that divine promise and the acceptance of that divine promise and the walking in courage with that divine promise that you don't have to worry about what to say or what to do in this world, that love will direct you and that everything can be healed. And to truly be so grateful when all the nonsense in your brain will dry up and you will no longer be tormented by what you thought you knew and just have the acceptance of I'm in the hands of God. I'm sitting with God. I can never leave. This is where I belong, because this is where I live. I live in this peace, I live in this light, I live in this harmony, because it's all that exists. And I gladly surrender all the nonsense that was my pain and suffering and my self-attack. The willingness to no longer want to self-attack with knowing, with conjuring up ideas of separation and needing to get and needing to have the outcomes as your mind thinks it should be. To put all fantasies aside, to drop them all, and to live here in this love, where you truly exist, where love is. All the nonsense in your brain will dry up like a stagnant pool of water beneath the sun, though if you want to know the truth, I can so clearly see that God has made love with you, and the whole universe is germinating within you.
Mm-hmm.
Acceptance.
Mm-hmm.
Acceptance.
Mm-hmm.
The place of humility that says, I don't know. I'm following those who walked before me. I'm following all the gifts of love that have been given to me in every moment of every teaching, of every divine offering I accept. Let me learn to take it in so deeply that it permeates into every cell and every old memory of the past, and the memories of the past disappear, and you are now recognizing, as the memories of the past disappear, that only love is real. There was never anything else. It was all a foolish dream. I'm happy to be called a pregnant woman if it helps me remember the truth. I'm glad to be turned upside down if it helps me remember the truth. I'm happy to receive whatever is most helpful, and I will not judge it, but let it show up and accept with love, with happiness, that this is all divinely orchestrated, because I said yes. When you said yes, everything became divinely orchestrated. The entire universe was welcomed in by your yes, accepting the mysteries of healing, accepting the beautiful, enlightened words that were bubbling and germinating within, to offer love. To let everything expand into the universe of love. And to really, truly relinquish not only all the nonsense in the brain, but relinquishing all energy into the hands of God to be used to express love. And to ride the energy of love in the everyday with a happy heart, all through surrender, all through trust. It all depends on the element of trust. To trust that everything is unfolding in perfect harmony. To trust that it isn't God's will for you to suffer. to trust that you don't know what anything needs to look like, but that it's always the perfect unfolding. To trust that every day is new. To trust that you are held and that you are the light of God. It is only because you think that you can run some little part or deal with some certain aspects of your life alone that the guidance of the Holy Spirit is limited. That's the only thing that's running. And the only way of letting that go is to realize that you thought you could run some little part of your life, that you thought you could deal with certain aspects of your life on your own. Kind of like saying to God, no, I got this. I've been here before. I know the layout of the land. I know how to work the world. And in that arrogance, the Holy Spirit can't enter. So it's a deep calling to find it, the love within yourself, the self-love, the loving kindness of your yes, that says, no, I no longer want to try to control certain aspects of my life and think that I'm in charge of them. I must surrender. Surrender what was nothing. Surrender the false concepts of being in charge. Even though everything in your entire journey seems to have been geared to perfecting and controlling the outcomes of situations and the everyday. And that you even looked at certain aspects and said, I'm finally getting the hang of this. I'm really in charge. It's all making sense now.
Mm-hmm.
And then love comes along and says, give it all to me. Give it all to me and come empty. Come empty unto love. Empty of all the illusions that you've made up. Just come. Come and let the universe germinate within you. The willingness to see the light that you are. And to want only the peace of God. The peace of God is everything I want. To declare that within your heart, it's a declaration of love, it's a declaration of kindness, of self-kindness.
Mm.
The peace of God is everything I want. Declaring your divine intention in that moment of sanity. The declaration, peace of God is everything I want. It is my purpose here. It is my function. It is my life. It's everything I want. And resting in that loving kindness.
Mm-hmm.
Resting. In the trust that in that declaration, that is all that you will have. That everything will become the truth of peace. And that everyone that you see, you will see through the love of peace. You will see everyone as the light and the peacefulness and the harmony of God. Since that's all that exists, there's nothing else to see. Nothing to know, only love. Dear teacher, you must be speaking the truth But all of what you say is a mystery to me. And the willingness to rest in that mystery. The willingness to rest in the mystery of truth. And trust with reassurance that everything will be revealed in perfect harmony, perfect time and space. Nothing is ever kept that is helpful, but trusting the divine orchestration of God's movement, that you don't have to worry. It's all in divine order. And you're held in that divine order. Everything is given that is most helpful. And all that you're asked to do is to accept that only love is real and that you don't know anything. To just keep coming back to that gentle, open contentment of the moment. And let love show you the way. Open that divine communion. And rest. The acceptance that nothing outside you can save you or bring you anything. The willingness to keep resting in the heart and affirming, Master, please open my heart. As my heart opens like a flower, I recognize the living God. And in that recognition, I create in the creation of God and within the oneness of all. One heart.